Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill. And today we are going to play with a Chinese hidden gem, WZ-131. Recently, I started playing with this vehicle in the Rus server. I am trying to get up to 100% of the mark of excellence as my challenge. And holy moly, it was amazing, right? I had so much fun. So today with this vehicle, I played 47 battles. Actually, I played 44 battles. I managed to get 1,700 damage, 1,300 assisting damage. But the most important thing what I want to say right here, this is not that good performance which I had, because the last one and a half hours of the stream was just everything went below down the hill, or however to say that. It wasn't that good. But the first 5 hours, I was like kaboom, 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 brrr. I was destroying everyone with this tank, so it was very, very fun and it was very, very enjoyable, right? And overall, we have 61 battles, we have 1,600 average damage and 1,300 assisting damage, which is great score, and we are going for 100%.
And still, I'm magically teleporting into the other day. He's looking like a psycho, like a maniac, and choo-choo!
I really wanted to do the intro yesterday. Why I wanted to do that, because my emotions was very, very fresh after playing with this tank for quite some battles, that's why. And the quick information for every single of you, my lovely friends, is, as you can see, we are using anonymizer idea, because it's a Russian server, and I said in Russian server I will use anonymizer. I do not use that in the EU server, so this is information for every single of you. The main reason why yesterday I did not finish the video overall, right, and you are seeing pretty much two parts of the video, is extremely simple. After stream, I was in a way wasted, right, so the games was not going too well, and I said, I will take a rest, and then we are going to make a proper video with this tank, right, so here we are now the other day. Instead of talking too much, what we are going to do, we are going kaboom, go and destroy everyone. This tank is amazing and I still love it with all my heart. If you are wondering what happened to my hair, don't mind me, I'm special, okay? My hair, everything is fine with my hair, so stop complaining. Okay, the first things first. What is happening over there? What I want to do, I want to spot the guys which is crossing like this, and soon we are going to have one or another heavy which is going in this way, right? That's what we want to do, that's what we want to have. Wait for it, patience, 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 patience. And if, and believe me, they will have some heavy tanks which is crossing not in the proper way, right? And we are going to spot them. Now the question is, when they are going to have those heavies which is crossing like this. 1 minute passed and all heavies crossed in the safe way. Ay, 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 ay. This is not what I wanted to see, but oh well, it is how it is. No complaints, no regrets, boys. Okay, what do we want to do? We want to craft a better angle towards the enemy forces right here, right? The Paris is not the map where I want to... where I want to play with this vehicle, but we are going to be fine. And my main goal over there is pretty much to make a pressure via the middle and simply destroy the people which is playing over there, right? Punish Chiri, punish Oni, and everyone which is playing over there. This is the plan for us, boys and girls. And that's what we are doing, and we are quite successful at it. At least that's what I think. And as you can see, Chiri is going to die in 1 second. Chiri is dead. This tank have an amazing gun. I truly mean it, fellas. The gun of this vehicle is so beautiful. It is literally insane. And this is probably the highlight of this tank overall, my lovely friends. The gun is amazing. Obviously, combination of the things is awesome too, right? You are the light tank, you can actually spot and you can get plenty and plenty and plenty of use. What do we want to do now? I'm thinking about being quite greedy over there. Why so? Because I think I can afford it. So we are going to drift a bit and we will try to destroy them one by one. So the first things first, we are going for this T29. Obviously we did not manage yet to hit him, which is completely fine. And we are going for the Su. Unfortunately, we did not manage it to penetrate Sura there, and I'm thinking, can I go for another one? And the answer is no, I can't. It's completely okay. The Sue is getting a bit more mad on us, and he is getting closer, and I changed my mind once again, so I'm going for that Sue ass. In this battle, we are not going to get too much assisting damage, but what we can get quite some damage dealt, right? This is the plan for us, and that's what we want to see. This T29, poor soul, he was stuck, and obviously he got destroyed. Meanwhile, what is happening right here? As you can see, the Sue is looking at us, and Sue wants to be quite aggressive over there, but we are not going to allow him to do that, right? We are using this position as properly as we possibly can. And now look, Schwarzmutz is over there. I'm getting tiny touch closer, and we are hitting Schwarzmutz into the side. Hip hip hooray. The Blade Prince is looking at us, and in the same time Oni is looking at us, and I'm down to one shotable already, which is not very good thing. But as you can see, the gun handling of this vehicle is actually very strong. I'm trying to peek sideways towards the Sioux, and luckily we managed to track him. Now what our Kravarevron needs to do, our Kravarevron needs to make a bit of pressure for this guy, and that actually happened. Hip hip hooray. So this battle, speaking about a map which we are getting and everything, it's not looking that epic, but it is completely fine. First of all, it is only the start. This is the first thing. The second thing is, as any light tank, it is shining the best in the open maps. Prokhorovka, Kempinovka, somewhere where you can actually use your speed, your camo, your mobility, and everything, right? So in this kind of situation, this tank is not looking that, this battle is not looking that epic, but oh well, I'm just accepting that. Now, what do we want to do? There is a Sue over there, right? I would love to hit him with a high explosives in the face, right? This is my dream, this is my goal, and this is what I am aiming for. So, you know what? I'm going to risk it for the biscuit right here. I'm going to peek over there to see where the bloody F this guy is. And as you can see, he is not over there apparently. So maybe he relocated. Oh, actually, he's over there, Russia. Good, we managed to eliminate him from the game, and now we are simply going for a shitter. Shitter might be prepared for us. We are hitting him with high explosive. We are getting some tracking damage, and we are getting all this tracking damage. Good, very good. So the first battle is solid 3,000 combined. 1,900 damage dealt and 1,200 assisting damage. I would say this is like average game, or yeah, let's call it average game for this vehicle. Like I said, it is amazing, okay? And the funny thing is, even though it is an average game for us with this tank overall, right? We supposed it to be top player in this team overall, right? And as you can see, definitely we are a top player right here. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Once again, fellas, I must admit, I forgot how this vehicle is behaving in the battlefield. I forgot what this tank is all about. And you know what? I must admit, I am in love with the Rus server challenge, which is to get up to 100% of the mark of excellence. And the main reason why am I in love with it, because I can discover and I can experience those vehicles once again, right? Like WZ-131, because it's just pure pleasure. It is heaven in a way, and it is bloody insane. By the way, let's fix camera a bit. Camera is fixed. Bleh-de-full. Okay, this battle have a big potential, and if we are not going to get 4,000, we will say boo for this battle. But overall, we have a potential right here, and I believe we are going to get 4, 5, or 6 grand in this battle. As you can see, there is some tank destroyers, there is a couple of lights, there is 3 Jeffs, so we can get a lot of use. Our mission is going to be to cross like this, but not in the first moment of the battle. First of all, we are going to take this position over there, and we will try to spot the crossing enemy forces. This is also very, very important, right? So let's see. And fellas, if you are a light tank lover, I would highly, highly recommend to test out this vehicle, because it is just amazing, my lovely friends. And believe me, I am not saying that about every single tank in the game. If the tank is good, I'm saying the tank is good, but if there is something bad about the tank, I'm saying this tank have this problem, right? Okay, so far so good. What is happening right here? We are simply trying to punish enemy forces for one or another stupidity which they are making. For example, this guy is going. We are at the middle of the field, and all we need to do, we need to keep beating the shit out of him, right? That's our mission. Plus, on top of that, we are the ones which is getting this assisting damage over there, which is very, very good. And you know what? I kind of want to keep crossing like this. And the main reason why do I want to cross like this? Because I want to collect all this assisting damage for ourselves, right? I know, greedy mother trucker, but sometimes greediness is the thing which you need to go for. Otherwise, you are not going to get enough, right? So, first things first, I'm just making a hardcore pressure like this, and remember, they have a MX-1375 over there, right? And believe me, we are going to start claiming his life very, very soon. By the way, he should be somewhere around this area. We are getting assisting damage from this IS. Hip hip hooray. We started this battle with a solid 2000 combined. And what happened over there? Unfortunately, enemy Arta managed to punish us, which is very, very sad thing. But in the same time, I cannot change it. So now look. The light tank is sitting over there, right? And our E25 simply spotted him. Now this light is going on the full bananas and we are hitting him once again. And our hotkeys should be able to finish him off. Hip hip hooray. Now look. Like I said before, this is only the start for our performance and for our battle. So next thing, what do we want to do? We want to start building a better angle. There is a super Hellcat somewhere, maybe over there. Or maybe they have, super Hellcat is over there. They have a Borshik right there and so on. But you know what? I changed my mind a bit. Why did I change my mind a bit? Ay. Because of the Arta. Unfortunate, very, very unfortunate situation right here. I could expect the clicker will try to shit on me from over there, but I was greedy. I thought I can relocate over there even though I'm spotted and I can start claiming the life of the people which is playing over there. So all those guys which you see right here, they are easy shootable from over there, right? So I thought it's going to be so much better, but oh well, what can I do? There is sometimes when you can't defend yourself from the Jeffs, right? And I was the guy which stepped on the same rake twice. I got hit by the Arta once. Why did I went over there twice? Well, you never know. Either way, I'm accepting that. Better luck next time and see you in a second. We will go for one more or two more battles with this vehicle and hopefully I will craft a better game right here because I'm kind of disappointed with first couple of games. I want to get this solid 4000 or 5000 game or something, right? Anyway, see you in a second. Peace. And we are back, fellas. This battle is about to end. I am still quite disappointed with this performance. I really wanted to get more use, and I said, if we are not going to get 4,000, it's going to be bad battle. So let's say we had a bad battle right there. Hashtag never lucky. Okay. Skill, you mother trucker, you need to get a better game. Hiya, Captain. Look, Hotkiss managed to get 3000. He did everything properly and he played this battle very, very well. Anyways, let's keep going, fellas. I believe we have a chance to definitely have a better battle with this tank. Once again, boys and girls, this tank is one of the best vehicles in the tier 7 light section for me, right? And I want to show you the very, very, very good things about this tank, right? And we are going to do it. Believe me, fellas, we are going to do it. Okay. They have quite some heavy tanks. We are going to start everything with a slow and safe gameplay. What do I mean by saying that? We are going to take this position over there. Maybe we will go for first scout run like this, I'm not entirely sure. But the main thing for us is to spot people which is playing around this area, okay? This is the main thing for what I am aiming for and what I want to do. So let's aim for 4,000 so skill can smile and skill can say cha-ching. One more thing. I haven't played with the light tanks for pretty much forever. And I'm so happy to come back home. It is insane. It's probably the same feeling like, you know, you left your hometown and everything. And after some time, you are coming back to your hometown to visit maybe your old friends or maybe your parents or maybe visit the locations where you used to live and so on, so on. So that's how am I feeling with this vehicle. I'm feeling just insanely good by playing with it, right? What the bloody F is happening right there? I want to spot and I want to do damage in the same time. This is my goal and this is my what I am aiming for, right? So let's try to get as much use as we can. By the way, T-44 is crossing like this, not a big deal. And this is only the start for us boys and girls, believe me. As you can see, enemy heavy tanks is trying to make some kind of crossing over there and I am feeling completely fine. Wait until the slower tanks will go, for example, Russian tanks. Unfortunate. Meanwhile, this guy is going super aggressively over there, which is allowing us to punish him. He is making another circle. We are going to punish him once again. And he is suiciding right there pretty much. I truly mean it. He is suiciding right there. That was very interesting play in a way. That was one-way ticket for the hotkeys. But, oh well, that was his decision, not mine, right? So, hotkeys is dead. How we could approach the enemy forces right there? This is the question of the day. And you know what? I am thinking about spotting this guy over there. I completely understand this is a risky thing, but I'm up to take this risk. I'm not going super ham right here. I'm going sideways, right? And I'm hoping to get a good angle to either spot someone or either hit someone. And as you notice, we managed to do that, which is very, very good for us, right? By the way, I am very, very aware that there is one Arta in this battle, okay? I'm extremely aware of that, don't worry. Now the question is, can we do something for Mr. LTG? And answer is absolutely yes. This LTG, he is being too aggressive over there, right? He thinks he can punish me, but in reality, he is the one which is getting punished right there, right? Okay, look. It is about the time to move for us. We are going aggressively with our hotkeys or hotkish or mini Ferrari, however you are going to call this vehicle, right? And we want to spot the enemies which is sitting behind, right? This is our goal, this is our dream. Because as you can see, enemy team is losing this side completely and my main mission is to spot bushwankers which is sitting over there. For example, Borshik. Look how many guns is looking at him. He is dead immediately, pretty much. He's dead immediately. We managed to hit him on the move, which is hip hip hooray. And Borshik did not manage to hit us, which is very, very nice. Now, I am just moving making hardcore pressure for them over there, okay? This is very important. Luckily, Borshik did not manage to eliminate us from the game, which is very, very nice. And the Super Hellcat is getting spotted here too, right? I'm trying to be safe next to the building and Super Hellcat should die for our forces over there. I'm just crossing like this, he is dead, hip hip hooray, and there is Arta over there, right? I could go like this for the Mr. Clicker, but I don't really think I care about that much, as wrong as it sounds, right? And plus on top of that, enemies have a lot of people in the city, right? Keep this in mind. So we will spot upcoming forces in the city very, very soon. All we need to do now, we need to be patient until the Arta is going to get killed. Whenever Arta is going to be killed, then we are going to go like this. Why am I not escaping immediately right now? I don't know. Actually, I think I can do that without bigger problems whatsoever. I hope Arta cannot shoot me through this place over there. This is my hope and this is my dream. Arta just shot. I don't really care. too much. And what we are going to do now, we are simply going to go into the city and we will try to get remaining... we will try to farm remaining of the enemies over there. We should spot this guy over there, but in the same time, majority of our forces can spot him themselves, so I don't have too much thoughts about getting assisting damage from this guy, right? Although, there is still cover on, which have full hit points, there is still cover 3, there is still Leo, and it's looking just amazing, right? So what we want to do, we want to get a better position for ourselves, so we can actually start punishing them, right? Mr. Leo is here next to the house. What we are doing, we are aiming for his side, we are punishing him. Now Leo is looking at us by having a mad face, like this. It is completely fine, fellas. We still can get a lot of use over there, right? At least I think we should be able to get a lot of use. Peeking sideways, trying to punish Leo. My reaction time was top-notch, but too bad we did not manage it to get as much use as I thought. Oh, we are going to get. By the way, I did not saw that one coming, and I did not expect this. I knew the 45 TP was over there, but I did not realize that he's going to have an angle on me right there. That was a bad play in the end. Oh, well, 2,500 combined. And once again, it is below average performance. Okay. Anyways, you need to, this time, my lovely friends, you need to trust me on this one. This is amazing vehicle. Sometimes you are getting those epic games and sometimes you are not getting those epic games. Unfortunately, this session or those three battles wasn't the finest and wasn't the best ones, but I truly believe this tank is one of the best light tanks in the tier 7. I did as much as I could over there, and we raised like 0.5% of the mark of excellence in the 3 games, which is not epic. And now, look, we are below our average damage, and we are pretty much below, well, we are in the same assisting damage. So you know what? Let's go for a fourth time. I mean, fourth battle. What could go wrong, okay? Fourth game, maybe fourth battle is going to be the charm, okay? Because, once again, boys... I can tell you one thing. For me, sometimes 3 battles is not enough to show how what the tank is made of and how the tank is working. So I'm still expecting to get the best performance on the 4th battle. Maybe we are going to get another ace vanker over there. Maybe. We'll see. Time will show everything. And soon, once again, we are going to have the games with WZ-131, and we are going to have the best showcase of the best battles, the most base experience battles, and so on. Because I had many 1.5, 1.6 base experience games, but I have a couple of higher ones. And you are going to see that. You are going to see what kind of decisions I made, and I will explain everything what I was doing and what I was thinking at the moment, right? And we are not having that often the commentaries in the channel anymore, because looks like you are enjoying the most the special content for YouTube, only for you fellas, which is a part of our channel, and hopefully you are finding this content interesting and informative in a way, and I hope funny. Okay. The last try with WZ to get epic battle or very, very nice battle. What we are going to do right here, we are heading into the middle and we will try to punish whoever is going to cross like this. This is the plan. Matchmaking is not bad. In a way, matchmaking is actually very, very good right here. So now the question is how to get maximum use, right? This is the question. So first things first, this bush is the bush which I want to take for a very first moment, and we want to punish someone which is going on top of the hill. As you notice that we punished this guy and we can punish him once again if I would not suck at aiming. That was quite bad aiming from my side, so I have no rights to complain about that, right? So pay attention over there. What is going to happen? I'm simply waiting until he is going to get unspotted, right? This is very, very important. He's unspotted, so I'm unspotted too. What we are going to do, we are trying to build a better angle, and this guy is going a bit more aggressive over there, and our Borat is making a pressure for this guy too. But I think our Borat went only for one. Now he's down to one shotable, which is hip hip hooray, and this light is probably thinking, holy bananas. That's what he is thinking right there. Okay. Let's try to focus on this battle and let's try to make it work. Let's hit him in the side, another 200 in the face, hip hip hooray. And you know what, after 10 seconds we are going to hit him for 200 once again, because this is how you are punishing this position, especially with the light tanks. We are going for it once again. We are having open angle to his ass. He's getting punished, he's getting spotted. I don't really mind, because I can go for him once again. And you know what, I don't really even mind after this, even though Arta could hit me, but I don't care. We are going for another one. I see this AMX over there, but I don't mind. It's not that easy to eliminate me from this position over there unless Arta is saying stop camping. But other than that, it is very, very complicated and relatively hard, right? Okay, pay attention over there. There is an STRV which is in the open field right there. So what is my mission? My mission is pretty much to be safe from this guy. It is very, very important thing, right? And as you can see, a couple of guys is in the back. I need to run. Borat is saying, wee! And Borat should take one for the team. Borat took one for the team. Now I want to see this STRV over there. Too bad I can't punish him. And you know what? We need to load the gold for the SU-100. This is looking very, very complicated situation for us, I can tell you that. And you know what, I am not going to wait until I am going to get flanked from the river on. I'm simply running for my life, and the main reason why am I running for my life is simple. Kerveron is here, AMX is here, Su is here. This is literally the deepest crossfire which I can be in, right? So I want to be safe, okay? I don't want to die in this game. I want to have a very, very nice performance over there. And plus, on top of that, why would I die, right? Now, wait. You see this AMX-1357? There is a big chance he might try to go on top. And if he is going to go on top, we will try to eliminate him from the game, right? That would be our game plan, but so far, it's not looking like it would be the case. Okay, very good. He made a mistake right here. Hip hip hooray. Soon, boys and girls, we are going to try to get the angle on Progetto. We will punish him once and then we are going to escape, right? So we are making a better angle right here for ourselves. What do I mean by saying we are making better angle? We are moving backwards. Aha. And Progetto is actually thinking himself about getting a bit closer right here, which is not that bad, as wrong as it sounds. It is not that bad for us, because we are giving information for our guys. Now Hellcat and Challenger, they might hit the Progetto in the face right here, which is very, very important, right? But as you can see, the first guy died over there, which is unfortunate, but it happens sometimes. Oh my bananas, that shot was... I wouldn't repeat that shot in 100 tries. That was insanely good. Now what do we want to do? We want to drop down a bit and we want to proxy spot the SU-101, right? This is the plan for us. Unfortunately, I tracked myself, but it's not a big deal and this is not a game changer yet. And what do we want to do? I assume, boys and girls, we want to either repush this side or either spot the SU-101. Progetto is trying to get an angle on me, but it's not going to be as simple as he thought, which is completely fine. And now look, let's not die for this cover too. Maybe I should play a bit more safe over there. Maybe this kind of stuff would work for us. Cover 2 is over there. If cover 2 would miss, I could claim his life without asking his name, right? So what we are going to do, we are going for this cover 2. I changed my mind and he spotted me. No! Yes. Cover 2 just missed. Okay, very good. That's what we want to see. Now what we are going to do, we are going ham on this cover 2, right? That's what we want to do. We are having auto aim, and I hope I am going to high roll for a next shot because the Sioux is in our back, right? This is very, very important thing. Obviously, since it's Russian tank, we did not high roll it, but it is completely fine, and we should be able to eliminate cover 2 from the game right now. Very, very good. I'm trying to run from this Sioux right here. We managed to escape from it. Hip, hip, hooray. And now three Artas. Now the question is, can I eliminate those three clickers from the game? It's very, very important thing. Now we are going to use the 200 IQ strategy. You see the Sioux? The Sioux is going like this. So we are going to return like this, and we are going to shoot him in the ass. So he is going to die. After that, we might go for Artas, okay? This is the plan, this is the hope, this is the dream. Wait for it, wait for it, wait for it. This Progetto, more likely, he's not looking at us, right? Su-101, where the flying F you are, buddy? Here he is. He's dead, hip, hip, hooray. Progetto is down to one-shottable. Now what we are going to do, we are going to go and deal with a Progetto, because I have a chance. I don't really think he's paying attention. As you can see, he's not paying attention and he is getting killed. And now what we are going to do, we are going to go for enemy Artas right here. Easy peasy. Actually, I could eliminate the Kravrevron of the game, but probably Artas is more important. Why Artas is more important? Because this Kravrevron won't be able to do anything for us. Actually, maybe I should go for Kravrevron. You know what? Let's go for Kravrevron. I should be able to hit him in the ass or wherever, and I should be able to kill him with a high explosives, okay? He's dead, bloodyful. Okay, easy game, fellas, easy game. So, look, this battle was perfectly played by us. We did as much as we could, speaking about the performance and speaking about decisions. We played this battle very, very well. So, as you can see, this tank is able to carry the games. I can promise you that. If not our player idea, we would that would be a defeat for our team. I can promise you that pretty much. But in the same time, hip hip hooray, I am very, very excited and very happy about this vehicle. So probably when you are seeing this video, I already third marketed. Well, third market is not the right thing. I already got up to 100% of the mark of excellence on this vehicle. And this tank is pretty much done for us. At least that's what I want to believe. If not, then you can say, skill noob, how dare you. Then you can say that. So pay attention. 280 meters, he shouldn't be able to spot me. At least I don't really think so. As you can see, he went for complete blind shot, which was not the best thing for him. Now we are getting tiny touch closer. We are eliminating this guy from the game. Now Excalibur is looking for the Hummel, and we should be able to kill Hummel. Three Artas killed. Hip hip hooray. 3000 damage, 600 assisting damage in this battle. We did everything properly, and I'm so damn happy. I decided to wait for the fourth battle for you, my lovely friends, and I hope you was well entertained right here. The fourth battle was the best battle, no doubts whatsoever. Hip hip hooray. So we have the Orlix medal, Dumitru medal, Top Gun medal, and obviously Ace Wanker with 1.5 base experience, just like this. I told you, fellas, I told you, the fourth battle is the charm for us. So what is the average performance? 1.8000 damage, which is better than average, or tiny touch better than average. And we have 1.2 average assisting damage and 4 out of 4 victories. I still have the same opinion about this tank, my lovely friends. I think it is one of the best tier 7 medium tanks. I'm having a blast playing with this tank. And if you are into the medium, if you are a light tank player... Did I said mediums? If so, I apologize. This is one of the best tier 7 lights. If you are into the light tanks, I would highly recommend to get this one. And just to troll around, just check it out, how everything is looking like, and just have a blast while playing with it, right? Anyways, that was your daily dose of skill. I hope you enjoyed this one, and I hope you had as much fun as I did. See you tomorrow. Tomorrow, what you are going to see, I have no clue, but soon you are going to see two very, very good battles with WZ, and I might get the third one, but I can't promise anything. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. See you next time. Skill is out. Peace.